Building a home can be exciting, but people often become overwhelmed or upset with the confusing home build process. So in today's video, I'm gonna give you my most important tips so you can be smart when purchasing a new construction home. Hi, I'm Ty the Real Estate Guy, and if you'd like to stay up to date on latest real estate tips and trends, subscribe to my channel and ring that little bell. If you have questions or comments at any time during this video, please leave a message below. And if you're looking to buy, sell, or build a home in Utah, please feel free to call or text. And at the end of this video, I'll make some recommendations that are sure to answer your other questions when it comes to building a home. Before we get rolling, I should explain that this video will be referring to Track home builders and not custom. Track builders are usually more affordable and they build out entire neighborhoods. I'll talk more about building a custom home in a future video. Tip number one, the first step is to always get pre-approved with a local lender. I recommend asking on social media or whatever to see if you have friends or family that would recommend someone. You can also talk to your realtor. Most real estate agents have a sincere desire to give their clients the best possible experience. A large part of that is to make sure you are working with the best possible lender. And as a realtor, we usually know the best lenders to use. If you're looking to build a home in Utah, feel free to reach out to me and I'll put you in touch with someone that I know and trust. Okay, so now that you have your loan approval, you know how much home you can afford and what your monthly payment will be. This is important because you don't want to waste a bunch of your time looking at homes that you can't afford. Number two, gain an understanding of the home build process. In my 15 plus years as a new home construction specialist, helping well over 500 people through the home build process, I can tell you that most of the time when people get upset, it's because they don't understand the home build process or have an unrealistic expectation of how long it will take to build the home. They don't understand that delays are common, and they don't understand that building a home can be sloppy. I'm not saying that home builders are just slapping homes together without care, though some builders might, but mistakes will be made and things will be done differently than what you expected. Fortunately, there are city inspections to make sure the home is built to code, and most builders have a superintendent to ensure mistakes are being corrected and that the home is being constructed to the builder's standard. The most common misunderstanding stems from the question, how long will it take to build my home? The actual time of construction is about 4 months. But if you're building a home from scratch, it will take an additional 4 to 5 months. So from the time that you write a contract to the time you close, 8 to 9 months could easily pass without delays. So far in 2021, we've had loads of delays. Things like labor and material shortages, with homes taking more than a year to be built. So because I love you, I recommend you watch one of two videos. Either the most in-depth video on the home build process, or if you don't have an hour, the home build timeline. Number three, understand all the costs associated with building a home. Often you'll see an ad or a billboard that says something like home starting at $300,000 or whatever. The key word here is starting at. The advertised price is the base price, and you should be prepared to add $30,000 at a minimum, but up to $100,000 or more. I need to explain that the advertised price is for the smallest home on the least desirable home site. So if you choose the largest home on the best home site, it's likely that your starting price will be tens of thousands of dollars higher than the advertised price, and maybe even $100,000 above that price. It's common for the builder to only offer a few zero premium home sites, so you should expect to pay at least a few thousand dollars for the lot. This is probably obvious, but the bigger or better the home site is, the more you're going to pay. You will want to ask the builder's representative for a plat map that shows the available home sites with the different lot premiums. If you'd like to take an in-depth look at how to choose the best home site, when you're done watching this video, you'll want to watch how to choose a home site. I'll put a link to this video below. Okay, so going back, the base price of the home is the starting price of the home that you've selected without the lot premium or the upgrades. When it comes to upgrades, there are two different types. There are structural options and design center options. Structural options are things like a 3-car garage or extending the back of the house out by a few feet. Your design center options are things like paint colors, flooring, countertops, cabinets, lighting fixtures, electrical fixtures, and etc. I should warn you, the cost of adding these features can add up quick, but most of these items will also increase the value of your home, and it's usually less expensive to add upgrades or make structural changes while you're building the home. You will also want to set a budget before you start making your selections. And to save some money, consider what you can do for less after you close on the house. This would be things like painting or upgrading electrical or plumbing fixtures. Things you don't want to do on your own after you close on the home would include cabinets, flooring, and the master bathroom. It's inconvenient to make these changes after the house has been built, and it probably won't save you any money. And by the way, the best place to put your money is in the kitchen and the master bathroom. When you're comparing one builder to another, it's important to understand that all builders were not created equally. It's almost impossible to compare apples to apples. So you'll want to ask for a list of their standard features. You know, what each builder includes in the base price of their home. The base price of one builder could be $20,000 lower than the builder across the street. But the more expensive builder might include $30,000 or more in standard features. Okay, number 4, negotiating. You should know that most builders will not negotiate. The base price of the home and the options are fixed. So the price is pretty much the price. Of course, it never hurts to ask, but because the costs are fixed, don't ask for a discount off the price of the home. Instead, ask for a credit towards closing costs or options. Once again, builders are not willing to negotiate, but a lot of builders will give you a credit for your upgrades or closing costs. More on this in a minute. Really, the best chance to get a discount is on a spec home, also known as a move-in ready home. Builders do not like to sit on completed homes. Or your chances for a discount would increase if you're in an extreme buyer's market and the builder is struggling to make sales. Now, just real quick, will you please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel? I would appreciate it more than you know, and it'll help others see that this video is helpful. And it allows me to produce more videos like this one to help awesome people just like you. Thanks. Number 5, closing costs. When you're buying an existing home, you might be able to get the seller to pay some or maybe all of your closing costs. When you're building a home, the builder will not pay your closing costs or give you credit towards upgrades when you're using what they call an outside lender. But often, the builder will pay some, if not all of your closing costs when you use their preferred lender. This is the lender that they know and trust and someone who specializes in new home construction. A lot of lenders don't understand the new home construction process and struggle to do these types of transactions. This often causes delays at closing, and builders hate delays. They're basically willing to pay thousands of dollars to know that you are qualified to buy the home and that you will be ready to close on time. And builders are always anxious to close because they don't get paid until you close on the home. Just so you know, most builders today will require that you get pre-qualified with their preferred lender, but they cannot force you to use them. I always recommend getting pre-qualified with both an outside lender and the preferred lender. Number 6, if you want to use a realtor, you need to bring them on the first visit. And I strongly recommend that you hire an agent with new home construction experience. Buying an existing home is completely different from building. Agents who don't understand the home build process often get confused and sometimes make things worse. If you know that you're going to build, interview real estate agents and ask them how many new home construction transactions they've done. Yes, the salesperson at the model home will gladly guide you through the home build process, but ultimately they represent the builder. If something goes wrong, you might wish you had someone looking out for your best interest. You know, someone who knows what questions to ask and someone who can talk to the builder for you. Most builders are happy to work with a buyer's agent, but the builders will not allow you to use a realtor if you already visited the model home, especially if you've been there on multiple occasions. If you're already working with a realtor and you happen to run into a model home real quick, just let the builder's representative know who you're working with, and that should suffice. If you find a home and you're ready to write a contract, just call your agent first. Number 7, what about home inspections? Well, in over 500 transactions, maybe 3% of the buyers have chosen to do an outside home inspection. Why is this number so low? Probably because most builders have a 1-year home warranty and they'll fix most things that go wrong for at least 1 year. Also, as I mentioned, the city holds its own inspections throughout the process to confirm the house is being built to code. That being said, if the builder seems to be cutting corners or you have concerns, then you should definitely hire a home inspector. Just remember that you need to get permission and schedule the inspection with the builder. Now, most builders will hold at least 2 different inspections with you. One is called the 4-way or the pre-drywall inspection. This meeting is held before the drywall or sheetrock is hung so you can see the bones of the house and inspect the electrical, HVAC, and plumbing. The second appointment is the final walkthrough. At this meeting, you'll have the opportunity to walk through the home with one of the builder's representatives to confirm that the house is built to your standards. It's important to understand that the home will have minor imperfections. There's no such thing as a perfect home. Houses are built by humans and with natural products. That being said, this is your final chance to ask questions and point out things that you think should be repaired or replaced. I've actually gone in depth on both the 4-way walkthrough and the final walkthrough for those of you who'd like more details. I'll put the links to both of these videos below. Also, many of you will be frustrated by the fact that builders will not give you an approximate closing date. The reason they won't is because too many things are out of their control. For instance, I've seen cities give builders a building permit in less than 2 weeks, while a different city once took 17 weeks to give us the building permit. This is just one part of the process that is completely out of the builder's control. Once the home is 30 to 45 days from completion, the builder will usually give you an exact closing date with the disclaimer that there could still be delays. The 45-day mark is usually after cabinets have been installed. At this point, any potential delays are at a minimum. That being said, you'll want to have an emergency plan for housing in case there is a last minute delay. Okay, so I have something to say to those of you who have control issues. You're just gonna have to let it go. Don't stop by the house every day and don't try to control the process. Simply put, the builder has a superintendent who is under a lot of pressure to build your home as quickly as possible and to the builder's standards. There's absolutely nothing you can do to speed things along. If you can't handle this, or you're someone who stresses out easily, you might want to consider buying a quick move-in home. Often, builders have homes that are already under construction or sometimes even completed. This way, you still get a brand spanking new home, but you get to skip the confusing and often stressful home build process. Now, because I've been doing this for so long, I've produced hundreds of videos to answer your real estate and new home construction questions. So as promised, here's a short list of videos to help you out. The guide for buying a new construction home. How to save money when building a home. 10 questions you should ask home builders. If you're planning to move to Utah or you already live here and you're looking to buy, sell, build a home, or invest in real estate, I'd love to talk with you. Please feel free to contact me directly. If there's something in this video that stood out to you as being helpful, or if you have questions, or if you think I left something out, please help the community by commenting below. If you know someone who's looking to build a home, please share this video with them. And please don't forget to hit the subscribe button below and ring the bell to be notified each time I post new videos. Also, you can find me on Instagram at Ty the Real Estate Guy. If you found this information helpful, please give me a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to ring that little bell below. It'll make you feel good.